Hey, what's up everybody, my name is TrophyNut and welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. In typical TrophyNut fashion, I changed my mind again. And we're gonna go for these ruins inside of the Embrace first, now that we have those on the map. And apparently, it's a hole in the ground. So let's take a better look inside here.
This old place. I haven't been here in years.
Oh!
Wonder what I can find.
This is exactly the same area as before, so maybe I can even check out that log I missed. I'm actually gonna check this entire area from top to bottom now. So there's a little... Can I actually shoot those rats? I can! Rat meat, tiny meat. Interesting. So now everything is on from the start. And they do actually drop stuff. Rat bone. Is there anything here? Maybe I can even use the power cell I found in here. Oh yeah, so this is the other way around. So if I'm not mistaken, we should go through this area. Oh, did we never listen to that one? Connor Chasson. Data corruption severe.
Seriously, record our thoughts for posterity. Great idea, Director Evans. Like I haven't done enough for posterity already. Like I wouldn't be here like this if not for posterity. I'm done with posterity. Posterity can go.
Okay. Bad words. I didn't bleep that out, by the way. Just stop. So I think if I head down here... Oh, blue. Rat skin. Ooh. If I head down here, there should be... an audio message that I missed because I didn't scan the correct item. But I'm wondering if there are areas in here that I just completely missed because I couldn't access them as a kid. So this is the thing we scanned before. And these are more living areas. Oh, there's something over here. Data corruption severe.
I saw them lining up in the community room. Like cattle in a slaughterhouse, but smiling at each other. Chana handing out meds, like being alive is some kind of pain to be eased. Well, not me. I don't want to go quiet. I don't want to trail off. I want a period at the end of my life sentence, not an ellipsis. Hell, an exclamation mark. So if that upsets whoever finds this, too bad. I don't know anyone, anything, anymore.
Whoa, okay, so that guy just blew his brains out. Yeah, I don't really see, yeah, he is kind of holding a gun. But okay, so a lot of angry, desperate people in this area. Can I scan that again? Because, oh.
Well, happy new year, dear.
Oh no, yeah, we listened to that already. Is there anything else? Can I open this door? Oh! I can, actually. There is no audio for this animation, apparently, but... Okay, so yeah, this is where we came from as well, if I'm not mistaken. We've seen all this. But I am... Ooh. Can I get... Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, yeah. Supply crate. Ooh, that's all mine now. And then another supply crate. Nothing of interest, but there's a lot of supplies in there. Doesn't seem like there's anything else. But that is interesting. So I can smack those open if I want to. And I can open up doors. So, wait. If I go back up here, I think... I should get to that one audio fragment I couldn't... Yeah, this thing. I need
the
to access...
There. I wonder if I can find a way into it now that I'm older.
There we go.
Director Evans, flash traffic from USRC. Black quartz encryption. I've routed the message to your hologrid for viewing.
Okay, was that it? And now I can smack this open, of course. And check out everything inside. Ooh... Lots and lots of stuff. All mine. All mine now. What's this? Ooh, another power cell.
Another one of these power cells. But what do I do with it?
Yeah, good question. Let's talk to this guy. Ooh, and that's Director Evans, probably. Let's view that in the notebook. From Director Evans to all good things. To all staff, I regret to inform you that our worst fears have been realized. The Wichita salient has collapsed, and our position will be overrun in less than 24 hours. As I'm sure you understand, exfiltration transport is not available. If you wish to abandon the facility and try your luck on foot, you may do so. Lock 2 will unseal at 2100 hours and remain unsealed for 15 minutes. Godspeed. For those of us who'd rather not die on our feet, there will be a gathering in the community room at 2200 hours, and Nurse Chana will make other means available. I want to underscore how proud I am of each and every person who served at this post. It is important to bear in mind that our sacrifices were not in vain. I hope that makes this a little easier. For months now, I've been signing off messages as Director Evans, but I suppose we can dispense with such formalities now. Respectfully, Ellen. The Wichita salient has collapsed. I have no idea what that means. So those are all the things we found. Looks, if they are in order, we now found everything, probably. Which is interesting. Huh. So something collapsed. The Wichita salient collapsed. I'm just gonna quickly look around if there are more rooms that I can smack open. Because I think, if I'm not mistaken, there should be a few more. Oh, yeah. At the very beginning, there's another room I can smack open. So let's take a look around. More supply boxes. Don't really need to crouch for that. Don't know why I did that. Accidental button press. Anything else here? Only one supply crate, it seems. Yeah, let me get that out of my way. I'm gonna go even deeper just to see if I can't find anything. But I don't think there's much else around here. So there go the bats again. But that's not bothering me anymore now that we're grown up. Yeah, here's another one. And there's something purple over there. There we go. Is that a metal flower? Yeah, okay, so that's those metal flowers.
Metal flowers. Huh. Well, why not?
A metal flower of unknown design, possibly used to promote seed germination, includes an embedded code fragment, trade sets of these flowers in Meridian for valuable rewards. Okay, so if I can complete the entire set, I can get something then. Okay. Fair enough. Anything else in this room? Doesn't seem like it. It's funny how it grows in between those flowers. But yeah, metal flowers, interesting. So, I checked out the rest of the cave and there wasn't anything left there. But that was really, really interesting. So now I'm gonna head back to the gate. And we're gonna head out of the embrace. So I guess I'll see you guys in a minute. Oh, and on the way, I found myself another strider, by the way, but there's somebody here that needs our help, apparently. So let's just leave our strider behind and let's talk to this guy. You look like a Carja.
There's danger ahead, girl.
Danger for you, Outlander. This is Noraland.
Yes, yes, yes. Trespass is forbidden on pain of death. Strange phrase, the pain of death. See? This one's in no pain at all.
Who was he?
A thief, slaver, a killer. The kind that give honest killers a bad name.
Fral told me there would be bandit ambushes on the road.
Well, it's not all good news. They don't always come to you. Most dig out a camp and there they'll sit like spoil on meat.
Unless someone does something about it?
I like you. Follow the trail of smoke on the other side of the ruins. I'll be there.
For what? To take out that bandit camp, I suppose. The bandit camp at Devil's Thirst. So that's what Varge was talking about as well. Really gonna check these corpses and get everything off that desert glass. And another dead guy. So this guy is called Nil. Nil. Okay, interesting. There's a merchant over there as well. Might want to talk with him too, because he might have a free supply box. Hello. Seems like you have pretty much the same... Yeah, the same inventory as the one near the gate. So I'm actually just going to get your free sample box and get out of here.
Good machine hunting across the river.
Ooh, yes, there is. Just going to do a quick save, literally, and then just head over there. Because that looks interesting. Shooting across the river like a bandit. There seems to be a lot here, and my marker still... No, my marker's over there, so... Just gonna take advantage of this. Hello? God damn it.
Gotcha.
Jesus Christ. This little fella is annoying. There we go. So there's this one here, and then we kill the grazer over there. And there's another watcher down. So let's take care of this grazer alongside his lens, because lenses are, I've seen those come up as trading items rather often. And I shot a few things off his back as well. So let's take those blazes with me as well. Hunting grounds and another watcher. Yeah, okay. Thank you very much for the damage coil. And then we're gonna just continue on our way to the gate. So give me a second. Oh, and we keep getting past some interesting things on the map, because Aloy just started talking about a frequency she can pick up. So I'm wondering what that is exactly. I saw something on the map. Just with a slight hint. Oh yeah, there we go. There's another metal flower in here. Oh. Wait. We're already outside. Never mind. Okay, that was unexpected. Because I didn't come from over here. I came from through the mountain. So that's why I never passed that gate again. I was kind of confused. So the hunting grounds are over there. But this... Ancient armory. Find a use for the power cell. Just gonna place a waypoint over there. Oh, so it's right here. So this is the hole where we need to go into. This seems dangerous. Do I just jump or... This is... What the hell? How the hell? Oh.
I don't know what's down here.
Do I just need to jump? Oh god. Hello! Okay. So it is water, so I should be fine. And there seems to be another metal flower. Hello there. Thank you. So mark 1F. So that means... Oh no. So that's mark 1. Part of the mark 1 set. Okay, then, fair enough. Anything else? Did we just find the end of this this area immediately? I don't think so, because now we're heading inside of a bunker. There seems to be some kind of suit over there. And I'm scared already. Do you guys see that? That over there.
From the age of the old ones. But how do I get to it?
Ultra Weave Armor. Experimental personal armor nanofiber construction with inlaid micro projector network. Fancy words, but that looks awesome. And I think I know what those power cells are for now. Just to get to that armor. Damn. So I kind of stumbled upon... So this is why it's called the armory, probably. But Must be able to put those power cells in here somewhere then.
Red light. I'm not getting in.
Okay.
I haven't seen one of these since I was a little kid.
Electromagnetic security mechanism with standard holographic UI. Interface unavailable. Okay. Examine breakers.
These devices are missing power cells. I'll have to find power cells to get these to work.
Okay, so let's repair one.
There. Fits. I just need to slot in one more.
Wait, what? Because I have two.
That's two. It's some kind of code. Maybe there's a clue nearby. I think the old ones use numbers like this to indicate time.
Okay, so which one do I need to take? 1200, 1500, 1800, 2100, 0, 0, 0, 0. So those are times indeed, but how the hell? Oh, never mind. So 12. Yeah, okay, so those are the hours. So 12 o'clock. This one is at 12 o'clock, technically. And then 15. Oh, so let's turn it clockwise.
Maybe there's some more information nearby. Something that will tell me
clockwise.
How
this works. Clockwise,
looks like
clockwise.
Each dial has four positions. Maybe if I get each dial in the right position.
And then six. So put it to six. And then nine.
Did it. Now to check the door.
Oh yeah, we did it. Wait. Do we get the armor immediately? Ah, there we go.
Maybe there's a way to power up the mechanism, release the clamps.
So we can't get to the armor yet, obviously. Let's check this out. Ultra Weave Trials. Wow, it's the last one. Dial pass threshold results. Ooh. Weave is not tightening properly on local impact tests. We need to optimize existing sensors or add more. Sensor optimization successful, but torso protection still lagging. Recommend increasing weave density. Getting there on the weave density and detection components, but an integration error on the left knee tanked the impact test. Ouch. Subject isn't going to be able to walk that one off. Surgery required. So they did live trials with this armor set. Interesting. This thing looks awesome. Very, very awesome. Kind of looks like a Hellghast armor, but then with blue lights. What else can we find here? Supply boxes? Ooh, yes. Thank you very much.
Forget about traveling light.
Yes, indeed. What's this? Come on. Yeah, scan that. Ultra Weave Progress. Major Garrow to General Aaron Harris. General, you want it fast, cheap, and good, and that's what we're going to deliver. By using a flexible nanofiber weave instead of plating and enhancing protection with a 400 EV hard light micro projector, we've reduced our testing cycle from weeks to days, and I'm confident we can get the suit out by next month, with enough production to cover dozens of elite units at least. Better yet, it will be half the weight, half the cost, and offer twice the mobility. All we need is the balance of our funding, a few more techs, and another experienced test subject. I know resources are stretched to the breaking point, but any more delays will jeopardize the schedule, so please advise ASAP. May God be with you and Jane in these dark times. Semper Fi, Major Garrow. So this was a military complex, clearly. And then we have this supply crate. Machine core large. And a few normal stuff. And I can't carry any more potions. And I don't think I can increase my potion pouch just yet. Yeah, we need a fishbone for that. So, what else is in here? There's another door over here. Oh.
Just need to install these power cells. That should do it.
Yeah, that is where we're gonna come short. So there's three more power cells in here, interestingly enough. Doesn't seem like there's anything else in here I can scan, but this is the way to open the armor up. Something
these
over
numbers,
there.
They must be related to segments of a circle.
Yeah, indeed. So the degrees. But that's not something we are going to be able to do right now. Interesting, so this must be high level gear then. Especially since I think the quest is level 25 even, so we've stumbled upon this rather early. But now, how the hell do I get out of here? Because I jumped down into a pit and I don't know how to get out. I think I know the answer already. I'm gonna have to climb out of this all the way back up. But that is interesting. So nano weave armor. I want that. So once we have 3 more power cells, we should be able to open up the clamps if there's no more surprises after that. And we know we can find power cells in the ruins, so we might want to have to take a look around for those then. Keep our eye open. But now we're going to head over there. There we go. And check out if we can find that war chief. Oh, there's the signal. Unknown signal. Oh, what is that? Something over there, but...
Where is it coming from?
Talking about fish bones. There we go, fish. I need the bones, though. So that's just bony meat and fatty meat. What? Oh, okay, so there's another watcher over there. I do want a fish bone. Any more fish in the water? There's one over there, but that's a bit far. Just gonna quickly take out those watchers.
Right on target.
More stuff for me. So I think they just ran away, all of them. But I killed a few of them at least. There we go, another watcher down. More arrows. God damn it, where did they go? Because I shot a few of them in the back. Yeah, there they go. There they are. Take everything from the grazer and then let's continue the hunt.
Okay, they're heading back.
Ooh, boop, boop, boop. There we go. Taken care of easily. But now, we want to head somewhere where that war chief is, and I'm still... There's so much to do, I keep getting distracted, I know. But I do want to get to that war chief in this episode, so give me a second. So it's right over there, shouldn't take that long. Oh, and there's something really big walking around over there. But this is amazing, actually, look at this. I thought we were going to see only wilderness in this game, but apparently I was mistaken. Severely mistaken. What the? Oh, Strider! There we go. Canister taken care of. That was an aggressive Strider. There's something else mad at me. There we go. Jesus Christ, what? What now? Fuck off! Stop annoying me! Well, the spear does pretty solid damage, actually. There's something. This seems like a scrapper over there. I'm gonna just ignore them and head to Mother's Crown, because that's exactly where we need to go.
Better.
And let's heal that up, and then take a little walk and build some more arrows on the way. Honora Village. Where? Ooh. So that's Mother's Rise, but we need to go over there apparently. Take one in the face. Thank you. Almost there. A lot of distractions around the way.
Such distraction.
Holy shit. Hello? We need to scan anything in here? No. Doesn't seem like it. Oh, wow. Don't know where the bodies went, though.
Honora managed to take down a corruptor. Maybe the war chief left something behind. Lots of machines. All controlled by the killers. They sent a stampede of them down the slope.
Wow. This is impressive.
Not before the killers used it to send the other machines against them.
Okay. Anything else we can find? What was that? Got a talk to the survivor. Hello? Where did you come from? Sir? Sir?
Brave! Let us speak!
Yes, I want to, Dran. Or Dran?
The dead and wounded all cleared away. Are there no more braves or healers here?
Just me. You're hurt. What happened?
What didn't? It's madness out there. War Chief Sona sent me back to report. I'm no good to her like this.
So, Sona's still alive, clearly.
Vara sent me to look for Sona. Do you know where she is now?
All I can tell you is where we parted. Near the metal tower, southeast of the ruins at Devil's Thirst. Look to the rise behind it with a lone boulder. I'll head for the Embrace and report what I know to Varl and the others. May All Mother lend you strength. You'll need it, going alone.
Well, I think we have an ally if we're going towards Devil's Thirst, because Nil will be able to help us over there. What are you doing? Are you just... Yeah, you're just in pain. Sadly, I can't help you, apparently, but... Yeah, I think... Wow, look at this. Would we be able to enter that building? That would be freaking awesome. I'm gonna take a little break, so thank you guys enormously for watching as a start, because next time we're gonna go to Devil's Thirst, probably alongside Nil, and clear out those bandits. But before we're gonna do that, I'm gonna take a little break, because yeah, I've been going on for quite some time. I cut out a few of the combat because I kept being stuck with a few machines in my way, and I wanted to kill them, of course. But yeah, it's starting to look like the open world is really, really opening up. And we're going to take advantage of that in the next episode. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.